أَفَلَمْ يَسِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ فَتَكُونَ لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ يَعْقِلُونَ فإنها لا تعمى الأبصار فإنها لا تعمى الأبصار ولكن تعمى القلوب التي ويستعجلونك بالعذاب ويستعجلونك بالعذاب ولن يخلف الله وإن يوما عند ربك كألف سنة مما تعدون كألف سنة مما تعدون وإن يوما عند ربك كألف سنة
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته and welcome back. وإن يوما عند ربك كألف سنة مما تعدون. This is the last segment of ayah number 47, chapter number 22, which is known as Surah Al-Hajj. And that means, and indeed, one day with your Lord is equivalent to 1,000 years of those which you count. So what does it mean? That would require us to read the ayah from the beginning. وَيَسْتَعْجِلُونَكَ بِالْعَذَابِ وَلَنْ يُخْلِفَ اللَّهُ وَعْدَهُ. The ayah means that the Meccan pagans, they urged Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to hasten the punishment, which he kept warning them, if you don't believe in God, if you don't believe in His oneness, if you don't keep your duty to Him, then you may incur His wrath and anger, and then Allah will punish you. So they say, bring it on. Not only that, they kept urging the Prophet ﷺ to bring on the punishment upon them. Show us the punishment. Show us the torment. Show us hellfire. And that is the meaning of يَسْتَعْجِلُونَكَ بِالْعَذَابِ. They urge you to hasten the punishment. And this is, of course, a sign of denial and disbelief. They dismiss the possibility of coming back to life after death. And that's why they were not afraid of what is going to happen next. And that's why they never kept their duties to Allah. And that's why they challenged the Prophet ﷺ and they said, why don't you bring it on? Why do we have to wait until the day of judgment? Just bring the punishment on right now. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commented on that and responded to that by saying, وَلَنْ يُخْلِفَ اللَّهُ وَعْدَهُ. Indeed, Allah will never fail His promise. As it is mentioned in a couple other verses in which Allah the Almighty says, وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حَدِيثًا and وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ قِيلًا. And who is more truthful in his saying than Allah? The answer is none. And who is more truthful in his promise than Allah? No one whatsoever. Allah is the most truthful. And whenever He warns, He will deliver. And whenever He promises, definitely He will deliver. Accordingly, He said, وَلَنْ يُخْلِفَ اللَّهُ وَعْدَهُ. Allah will never fail His promise. So if you disbelieve, you will not be eligible for His mercy, and most certainly you will be punished. Then He followed that by saying, on the Day of Judgment, the number of days according to Allah, and with Him, each day is similar to 1,000 years of what we count. And this is plenty of time. Yes, indeed. There is another ayah that we found in Surah As-Sajdah, chapter number 32, and it is the fifth ayah in the chapter, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us how He runs the affairs of our world. He says, يُدَبِّرُ الْأَمْرَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ ثُمَّ يَعْرُجُ إِلَيْهِ فِي يَوْمٍ كَانَ مِقْدَارُهُ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ مِمَّا تَعُدُّونَ. Allah the Almighty arranges each affair and matter from the heavens to the earth. Then it will ascend back to Him in a day, one day, which is equivalent to 1,000 years of what you count of our days and our years. And the Mufassirin and the interpreters of the Quran said that when Allah the Almighty decrees a matter and He sends the angels with it to our earth, the distance between the heavens and the earth is 500 years coming down. And then ascending back is another 500 years of our time. And this 500 plus 500 is only 1,000, but it is only one day before Allah the Almighty. وَإِنَّ يَوْمًا عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ كَأَلْفِ سَنَةٍ مِمَّا تَعُدُونَ. This one single day with Allah is similar to 1,000 years of those which we count of our time. But when the angel descends and then he ascends with our deeds, that doesn't take even a blink of an eye, not even a day of our time. And that's why in the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, while glorifying the Almighty Allah, he says, يُرْفَعُ إِلَيْهِ عَمَلُ اللَّيْلِ قَبْلَ عَمَلِ النَّهَارِ وَيُرْفَعُ إِلَيْهِ عَمَلُ النَّهَارِ قَبْلَ عَمَلِ اللَّيْلِ. What does it mean? The deeds, the report card of our deeds, whether good or bad, are being presented before Allah on daily basis, not every 24 hours, no. The deeds of the day will be raised unto Allah before the night is over. And the deeds of the night will be raised to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the angels before the day will come. So constantly the deeds are being presented before Allah the Almighty on a regular basis. But He just said that ascending and descending takes one day, and this one day with Allah is similar to 1,000 years of our time. This is for us. But for Allah and for His angels whom He sent down, that is similar to a blink of an eye or even less. This is the like of the number or the length of the day with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and on the Day of Judgment, and in heaven and in hellfire, which also reflects that those who will be tormented, God forbid, and may Allah protect us again, is that in hellfire, the day would look so long, like it is forever, and that is only one day. Because وَإِنَّ يَوْمًا عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ كَأَلْفِ سَنَةٍ مِمَّا تَعُدُّونَ. We hope and we pray that Allah the Almighty will grant us salvation on the Day of Judgment, and we will not experience a single moment out of paradise. Rather, from beginning to end, we will be enjoying the pleasure of being hosted by Allah in His heaven. Ameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.